By the end of the year 2015, the senior management of Rostavi Metallurgical Plant have made a decision to implement certain changes in the way the slag processing unit operates. The changes were made in order to increase the quality of distribution product and to meet the newly established industry standards. To achieve that, we have run the product analysis along with the equipment check. We've managed to determine problematic areas and all the shortcomings that the AMCOM equipment appeared to have, all of which was aimed at the further reconstruction of the AMCOM unit to improve the production method and increase the product quality of commodities for internal consumption, as well as to prepare the product for the external customer groups if needed. The analysis has revealed that the slag processing unit was capable of extracting the fraction of 0.16 mm, 16 to 60, 60 to 250, 250 and higher. The iron content of 0.16 mm fraction was somewhere around 37%, so that kind of product had no practical use whatsoever, neither for our own production nor for our customers' needs. The issue of 16 to 60 fraction also wasn't any good. The content had a negative effect on the chemical composition of steel we produced, which is why it was also a big question that we had to think through. We've decided to run a complete modernization of the slag processing unit. The whole system has undergone a fundamental change. We've chosen the most suitable way and recognized the method of fraction separation and peeling. The reconstruction started in June, and by August the streamlined unit was up and running. So it took us about a month to complete the process. It took us about half a year to produce the equipment. There were different types of equipment, some of which took up to 6 months to manufacture. So at the moment, our unit is capable of producing a radically different product in terms of the fractional composition. Thus, we can definitely see a general increase in quality. Today we get the fraction of 0.60 and 16 to 300, as we've combined the dimensions of 16 to 60 and 60 to 250. And so now we get the fraction of 16 to 300 as well as the 300+. The cleaning system that has been installed during the modernization process of the unit allowed achieving rather high levels of metallic iron infusion, which in its turn has allowed metallurgists to use 70% of scrap as part of the batch during melting. At the moment, the 0.16 fraction contains about 76% of metallic iron, which makes it suitable for melting, although its shape might be a bit of a problem. We're currently working on it and are planning to design packaging and use a kind of briquettes for the loading that is more convenient. That way it won't cause much trouble in the furnace. I think we'll manage this problem in the nearest future. We've managed to increase the scrap consumption drastically in our personal production. The scrap quality has no negative effect on the steel melting process. The current way of scrap usage improved the overall factory economy, giving positive and promising results. Right now we're busy with the blast furnace slag equipment reconstruction. Surely, we're facing certain problems, but I'm feeling pretty positive and sure that we'll be able to sort things out quite soon. At the AMCOM plant, we've got fractions of 0 to 16, 16 to 60, 60 to 250, and 250 plus. For the 15-ton amount, we're using an electric arc furnace of 60 to 250 and 250 plus fraction. We didn't use 0 to 16 and 16 to 60 fractions as they were too contaminated and had a very low content of metal. After modernization, we were able to get the fraction of 0 to 16, 16 to 300 and 300 plus. At the moment, the scrap is fully utilized and the total batch share is 70%. Such parameters as melting duration or power consumption per ton remain the same. As for 0 to 16 fraction, it makes about 5 to 7% of the overall turnover. We tend to experience certain troubles with this particular type of fraction. It's good and contains a lot of metal, but the problem is that when delivered, the scrap clogs the furnace. We are currently working on this problem, and as soon as we manage to fix this issue, we'll be able to increase the amount of scrap in the furnace. We're doing this because at the moment, there are certain problems on the ferrous metal market. These problems are related to the quality and quantity of the metal, although it is absolutely convenient from the feasibility point of view.